father was asked by an acquaintance to set up some equipment and software for Dr. John Jackson, who many of you probably know by name. He is one of two lead scientists who formed the Shroud of Turin research project, which went over to Turin, Italy, and performed a series of tests on the Shroud. And Dr. John Jackson has been behind much of the research that's been done on the Shroud of Turin since that time. But the first time I heard about the Shroud was when my father was asked to set up that equipment and that software, which allowed Dr. Jackson to plot cross-sections of geometric data that was taken from the Shroud, and then that information was used to build a statue of the Shroud. And the statue was placed on display at the Air Force Academy in Colorado Springs, which I believe is still there. I haven't been to the Air Force Academy since, it's been since at least 9/11 of 2001. I'd been there shortly before that occurred, and I haven't been there since then. But of course, I also learned about the carbon-14 test results when they came out, and at that time I thought that was the end of the Shroud of Turin. But then in 1999 I saw that program, Jesus and the Shroud of Turin, on the Discovery Channel, and as I said, the scientific evidence convinced me that this was indeed the burial cloth of Christ, and for me the inexplicable image on the cloth was proof of the resurrection. And I believe that's the whole message of this cloth, the resurrection of Christ. And I've been a Christian since that time. But I wanted to go over this new story that came out today, this new study. It's been in several places, and the news has, the news of this study has been on a lot of websites and on a lot of news channels. The article I'm looking at right now comes from the Mail Online, and this is one of the better articles that I came across, and I thought I would read some of it and comment on it. Now the image, and this is from that article by David Wilkes, and it says, "The image on the Turin Shroud could not be the work of medieval forgers, but was instead caused by a supernatural flash of light, according to scientists. Italian researchers have found evidence that casts doubt on claims that the relic, said to be the burial cloth of Jesus, is a fake, and they suggest that it could, after all, be authentic. Skeptics have long argued that the shroud, a rectangular sheet measuring 14 feet by 3 feet, is a forgery dating to medieval times. Scientists from Italy's National Agency for New Technologies, Energy, and Sustainable Economic Development spent years trying to replicate the shroud's markings. They have concluded only something akin to ultraviolet lasers, far beyond the capability of medieval forgers, could have created them. This has led to fresh suggestions that the imprint was indeed created by a huge burst of energy accompanying the resurrection of Christ. According to these scientists, their tests showed that a short and intense burst of UV directional radiation can color a linen cloth so as to reproduce many of the peculiar characteristics of the body image on the Shroud of Turin. The report concludes that the image of the bearded man on the shroud must therefore have been created by some form of electromagnetic energy, such as a flash of light at short wavelength. And though they stop short of offering a non-scientific explanation, they admit that the kind of technology needed to create the Shroud of Turin simply wasn't around at the time that it was created. Professor De Lazzaro, who led the study, said, "When one talks about a flash of light being able to color a piece of linen in the same way as the shroud, discussion inevitably touches on things such as miracles. But as scientists, we were concerned only with verifiable scientific processes. We hope our results can open up a philosophical and theological debate." The article goes on to say that in 1988, radiocarbon tests on samples of the shroud at the University of Oxford, the University of Arizona, and the Swiss Federal Institute of Technology dated the cloth to the Middle Ages between 1260 and 1390. Those tests have been disputed on the basis that they were contaminated by fibers from cloth used to repair the shroud when it was damaged by fire in the Middle Ages. In other words, the section that was tested was contaminated by threads used in a complex patch job. I think that the timing of this research is very appropriate. It's just 4 days short of Christmas. Of course, many are taking offense at this article and its timing, seeing it as Christian propaganda, but the shroud is evidence for the resurrection of Christ. And since Christ was resurrected, it substantiates every claim that he ever made. And he claimed not only to be the Son of God, but equal with God. He claimed to be the only way to heaven. He said that those who saw him had seen God. He claimed that he came out of God, like a flame emerging from a fire. In fact, Colossians 2:9 says that in him all the fullness of deity dwells in bodily form. So this study of the Shroud of Turin is an important one, and I hope that you will seriously consider it. Now, that's all that I have time for today, and as always, I'd like to thank you for listening to Prophecy Pod Radio. I hope you will join me next time.